Hello everyone, welcome. Today we are going to do a little bit of a more fiery flow, but I want to do a really short Chaturanga tutorial before we get into that flow. I will put a timestamp on the YouTube video in the description box below so that if you don't need the Chaturanga tutorial, you can just hop right forward to the flow class. I have not necessarily taught and practiced a more fiery class, so we'll see how it goes. Excuse my breathing. I will try my best to maintain an ujjayi breath as I practice this along with you. So, Chaturanga Dandasana. Whew! I'm gonna try and make this quick. Just two main points that I want to go into with Chaturanga. So the first main point is your hands are actually next to your low ribs. They're not underneath your shoulders. So the first piece is that your hands are next to your low ribs and you want to be using your triceps and your back muscles here to help you to lower with control. So that's piece number one. And really the whole action is that it's a transitory motion into upward facing dog. So Chaturanga Dandasana is not a touch down. And a lot of the times we see students dip forwards, which puts a lot of pressure on the anterior deltoids here. So we do want to try and think about this is leading into a back bend, which is upward facing dog. So piece number one, elbows in, hands are next to your low ribs, and then you're leading into a back bend. So we don't want the shoulders to dip forward. I will show you that in just a second. Piece number two is also just as important. When we're making that transition from that halfway lift in a Surya Namaskar, in a flow, we do wanna make sure that we don't jump into high plank. So if you insist on jumping, and there is absolutely no reason to jump back, if you insist on jumping back, or if that's something that you really love to do, please, 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 please jump back into Chaturanga. So into that low plank position, push-up position, not into that higher up plank position. Most of the time in my classes, unless I'm letting you just do your own vinyasa for whatever reason to flesh it out, I will suggest stepping back. Also, specifically for this next flow, stepping back, because most of the time we're going to hold a plank position. Yay! Get the core working as well as we go through it. Plus, it's an opportunity to just kind of re-catch the breath. So I will show you those two little pieces. First off, when we are coming into that halfway lift, again, Chaturanga is that preparatory stage. So you come, plant the hands, step back, pull the collarbones forward. So already you can kind of see a little bit of that back bend action. Lower, and then lead yourself up and forwards. So that's the big piece. Now, when it comes to jumping back, again, we are not going to be, for the most part in this flow, doing anything but stepping back, because we will be holding that plank pose a lot of the time, spoiler alert. If it comes to jumping back, you bend your knees, cushion your elbows, and you jump into Chaturanga, and then you flow into your upward facing dog. Okay. I hope that was short. Let's jump into a flow. So we're gonna start off in an extended child's pose or puppy pose. So knees are going to be underneath your sitting bones, so a little bit further back there. And then you're gonna melt your chest forwards and down. Now, if you need a block underneath your head, go ahead and put a block or a book or whatever you need under your head. And you're just gonna melt your forehead down to whatever that happens to be. Arms are long and lifted. And then plug
your shoulders, wrap them externally and then in. So you almost have downward facing dog arms. Actually, you do have downward facing dog arms. And your spine is really long here. Try to hold your low ribs up and in. And glue down through the inner edges of your hands. So again, you've got that downward facing dog action in your arms and your hands. Try to tug your hip creases back. So you're lengthening your spine. Get as much traction as you can here. And see if you can cultivate that ujjayi breath. Last breath. Good. Come up forwards and then slide yourself forwards and down onto your belly. Land your hands next to your low ribs. So again, that's that Chaturanga position. Elbows hug in and back. And then inhale, lift and open your chest. Toes are pointing back behind you. Exhale, lower yourself back down. Inhale, lift and open. Exhale, lower back down. Really using the back of your heart, your spine, your back muscles to pull you up and open. And exhale, lower. Inhale, press back up, hands and knees, and then slide your knees forwards to your wrists. Take your hands back behind you and externally rotate through your arms so that you're spreading wide across your collarbones here. You can keep your bum on your heels, or you can pull your pelvis forwards and up, just depending on how open your front and back body are feeling right now. Try to keep your gaze down your midline here. So we're not dropping the head back in this moment. Your hands can be on blocks or books if you need. Good. Take another breath in. And as you breathe out, lower yourself back down. Place your hands up forwards to the top of your mat. Step your legs back, downward facing dog. So we are entering the downward facing dog a little bit earlier on in the practice and really get into the shape here. So pedal out your heels. If you're anything like me, quarantine, isolation, social distancing, the yoga practice may not be as consistent as normal. So that's okay. You're not alone. Just notice where your body is today. Notice what your body is needing. Notice if it is open, if it needs a little bit more space. If today you need to bend your knees in your downward facing dog to get into your spine a little bit more, just give yourself that time to shift into whatever is required here. Another breath in and breath out. Inhale, look forward between your hands, bend your knees, and then step yourself up to the top of your mat. Feet about hips width apart. And drop your head, soften your knees, and just let your torso drape over top of your thighs. You can cup opposite elbows if you like that shape. And you could give yourself just a little bit of a bounce, which helps to release the fascia. Whatever you're up to, whatever you're doing, go ahead and slow it down. Come back to stillness. Release your hands to your shins or to the floor. Inhale, lift up, open your chest. Exhale, fold down, soften. Inhale, lift up, open your chest. Use your shins or the floor to pull your sternum forwards. Think about that up dog.
Exhale, soften. One more inhale, lift and open.
And exhale, let it go.
Gently, softly roll, bend your knees and roll up your spine. Head, neck, and shoulders arrive last. As you roll up, roll your shoulders up, back, and down, and then reverse the action. Shoulders forwards, collapse through your abdominal wall. Pull your spine round. Soften your knees gently all the way down to the floor. As you arrive at the bottom, reverse the action. Knees are soft. Pull your abdominal wall up and in. Roll up through your spine. Shoulders up, back, and down as you arrive at the top. And again, collapse your arms forwards. Belly pulls back. Curl through your spine. Head, neck, and shoulders are super soft, super heavy. Let the crown of your head fall down towards the floor. Last one, roll yourself back up. Really feel the articulation in your spine. Notice if there's any sticky points here. Shoulders up, back, and down as you arrive. And then, just for good measure, another shoulder circle. All right, inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, fold down. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, plant your hands, right foot steps back, lower your right knee down to the mat. Inhale, arms reach up.
Root down through your sitting bones, cup opposite elbows with each one of your hands. Low ribs pull back, and then see if you can pull your elbows back. So you're framing more the back of your head as much as you possibly can. This is gonna feel a little bit of a stretch through your armpits, as well as maybe through your chest. And then try to drop your shoulder blades down your back. If you are more open, you're welcome to take a little tiny tip towards the left. Now, if that hikes your shoulders and your hips up and you get all sticky, go ahead and don't do that. Good. Inhale, come back through center, reach up. Exhale, frame your front foot, step back, high plank, and we pause.
Hands underneath your shoulders, inhale here. Try to pull your elbows in towards each other. Feel a buoyancy in your chest. Inhale. And exhale. Really strong in your legs. Inhale. And exhale. One more breath in. And exhale, lower yourself forwards all the way down.
Hands tent next to your, off your mat, next to your low ribs. Elbows point up towards the ceiling. Inhale, lift and open your chest.
Exhale, lower.
You can lift up any or as little as serves your body. Inhale, ripple up.
Exhale, ripple back down.
One more time, inhale, ripple up.
Exhale, ripple back.
Inhale, press back up, hands and knees only.
Exhale, sit your bum to your heels.
Fingertips come back behind you. Inhale, lift and open your chest. If you want, you can peel your sitting bones, your pelvis, off of your feet. Again, gaze is forwards and down. Last breath. Inhale, and as you exhale, sit your bum back down, drag your fingertips forwards on your next breath out, downward facing dog. Notice if anything has shifted, if anything has changed, if anything feels a little bit more expansive here. One more breath.
Inhale, look forward between your hands, bend your knees, step up to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold down.
Flat back, inhale, stand up, reach up. And exhale, dive forwards and down.
Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, plant your hands, left foot steps back, lower your left knee down. Inhale, arms reach up.
Root down through your pelvis, feel the low ribs pull back and in, and then cup opposite elbows. Now, here's the fun part. switch your grip. It feels so weird. All right, slide your elbows back. Try to drop your shoulders, drop your pelvis, and then pull your low ribs back and in. If it serves you, if your body has space, you can take just that little teeny tiny tug towards the right. Now again, if that clams you up, if that pulls everything into a tight, tense position, don't do it. Feel that length through the entire left side of your body. Whew, try to drop your shoulders. Mine are really not wanting to do that today. Good, inhale, come back up through center, reach up. Exhale, frame your front foot, step back, high plank, and pause. Full breath in, and breath out. Collarbones open, inhale. And exhale. Strong in your legs, breathe in. And out. One more breath in, and out. Inhale, and exhale, lower all the way down. Hands stay next to your low ribs this time. Inhale, lift and open your chest. Exhale, lower. Two more, inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift up. Now this time you can stay here, or we're gonna come into upward facing dog just to practice that action. So push down through your hands, tops of your feet are on the mat, and then push down through the tops of your feet, lift your thighs, your pelvis, and push your arms down. Whoo, yeah, collarbones open. So if you are on your belly, you are going to press up hands and knees or high plank. If you are in upward facing dog, you're gonna roll back over your toes, send your hips up and back, downward facing dog. And we meet in downward facing dog. So you always have that option to lower all the way down to your belly. Take a cobra pose and then take the extra inhale to lift yourself back up, and then exhale to downward facing dog, because we always spend a few breaths in downward facing dog. So you can always add that extra breath, which is what typically I teach. All right, inhale, look forward between your hands, bend your knees, step up to the top of your mat. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, breathe out. Inhale, stand up, reach up. And exhale, dive forwards and down. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, plant your hands, right foot steps back, lower your right knee. Inhale, arms reach up, cup opposite elbows. Low ribs in, pelvis down, elbows back. Your choice, you can take that ever so slight tip towards the left. You might feel a little bit more space this time. Inhale, come back through center, reach up. Exhale, frame your front foot, pick up your back knee, runner's lunge, breathe in. Exhale, keep your front knee bent, curl and round through your pelvis, through your back. Inhale, open your chest. Exhale, curl and round through your back. Inhale, open. Exhale, curl. Inhale, lift and open your chest, plant your hands, step back, high plank. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Breathe in and out. Inhale, pull your weight forward. Exhale, flow through whatever variation of a vinyasa is what is going to serve you today. We meet in downward facing dog. Light up your legs, drop your head, your neck, and your shoulders.
pull your upper arm bones towards each other. As you breathe in, reach your left leg up and back. And as you breathe out, curl it in, knee to your chest. Inhale, stretch it up and back. Exhale, curl in, knee to your chest. Pull in through your abdominals. Inhale, reach up and back. Exhale, curl in. Now step your left foot forward. If it doesn't get there on the first try, just move it forward so that your left heel is on the mat. Inhale, lift and open your chest. Exhale, hips go up and back. Try to straighten out your left leg as much as you can. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, hips back. Inhale, forwards. And exhale, hips back. One more time, breathe in. And exhale, back. Inhale, soften your front knee. Exhale, step forward, forward, fold. Halfway lift, breathe it. Exhale, fold down. Flat back, inhale, stand up, reach up. And exhale, dive forwards and down. Halfway lift, breathe it. Plant your hands, exhale, step your left foot back, lower your left knee down. Inhale, arms reach up, cupping opposite elbows, and then switch the grip. Lower ribs tuck back. Shoulders drop down, pelvis is rock solid. And then if you want, ever so slightly, tip your right elbow towards the floor on the right. So your right heel and your left knee are trying to connect each other. Inhale, come back up through center, reach up. Exhale, frame your front foot, pick up your back knee. Runner's lunge, inhale. This time, exhale, just curl through your spine, your pelvis. Front knee stays bent. Inhale, open your chest. Exhale, curl. You can always have books or blocks underneath your hands. Inhale, open. Exhale, curl. Good. Inhale, open your chest. Exhale, frame your front foot. Step back, high plank, and pause. Breath in and breath out. Inhale and exhale. Try to root your sitting bones towards your heels and pull your heels forwards. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Move through your vinyasa so it might be all the way down to the floor. We will meet in downward facing dog. Do what you need to do. Shift and move. Find your down dog as your body has opened up just a little bit more. Work into your legs. Pull length in your spine. As you breathe in, reach your right leg up and back. And as you breathe out, curl it in, knee to your chest, round through your spine. Inhale, reach up and back. Exhale, curl it in. Inhale, open. And exhale, pull in. Now step your right foot forward between your hands. And if it doesn't get there on the first try, just walk it up there. Inhale, open your chest. Exhale, straighten out your front leg. Inhale, bend forward. Exhale, hips back. Inhale, forward. And exhale, hips draw back. Good. Inhale, soften into your front knee. Exhale, step forward, whoop, forward fold. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, fold down, soften. Flat back, inhale, stand up, reach up. Exhale, dive forwards and down. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, plant your hands, right foot steps back. Keep your right knee lifted. Inhale, runner's lunge. Exhale, hips draw up and back. Inhale, forward. Exhale, hips back. One more. Inhale, forward. Exhale, hips draw back. inhale forwards, plant your hands, step back, high plank. You can hover your left foot. If you are hovering your left foot, you can stay here, or you can exhale, curl it in. Extend out, inhale. Exhale, curl. Inhale, extend. Exhale, curl. Inhale, extend out. Exhale, flow through your vinyasa. If you're taking up dog, touch your left toes down as you move into that upward facing dog. And lift yourself up and back as you are ready for downward facing dog. Inhale, reach your left leg up and back. And as you exhale, step your left foot forward and through, coming into warrior one. So your back foot is gonna hop up, pivot on a 45 degree angle, front knee is bent. Inhale, whoop, come on up. Root down through your sitting bones so that you feel that same opening in your right side body. Now your choice, you can take opposite elbows here, just as we've been doing, lower ribs hug in, or if you want, you could take opposite elbows behind you. You can't quite see that. Or you can take reverse prayer. So hands come whoop, together up your spine, shoulders back. Whew. So we're opening the chest, the front body, and your legs are super strong here to help you get into your right hip flexors. Try to lengthen up through your spine. As you breathe in, straighten out your front leg. As you breathe out, bend into your front knee. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. Good. Inhale, lean your chest a little bit forward. So if your hands are over your head, you'll want to either bring them to reverse prayer, grab opposite elbows, or interlace your hands behind your back. Your choice with the arms. Lift yourself onto your left foot. Sprite. I don't know. Lift your right foot up. Warrior three. Try to lift your elbows, your shoulders, your collarbones, your low ribs away from the mat. Another breath in here. As you exhale, hinge forward, forward fold, release your feet down to the mat. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, fold down, soften. Flat back, inhale, stand up, reach up. And exhale, dive forwards and down. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, plant your hands, left foot steps back, keep the left knee lifted. Inhale, lift and open your chest. Exhale, hips draw back. Straighten your front leg. Inhale, forward. Exhale, hips pull back. Inhale, forward. And exhale, hips back. Good. Inhale, come forward. Plant your hands. Step back. Your choice. You can keep your right foot hovered. You can lower it down. You can lower onto your knees. Or you can stay here. Inhale. And if you want, exhale, knee into your chest. Inhale, extend. Exhale, curl. One more time. Inhale, reach. Exhale, curl. Inhale, open up. Exhale, flow through. Whatever variations, you might lower all the way down. Or you might come into upward facing dog. I'm just changing it up to remind you that you have options. Do what you need. I should also say that at any time in downward facing dog, you're also welcome to tap out and go to child's pose instead. All right, as you breathe in, reach your right leg up and back.
As you breathe out, step your right foot forward and through, setting up that warrior one shape. Back heel pivots down on a 45 degree angle. And inhale, come on up. All right, your choice. You can take opposite elbows above your head. Remember to switch the grip. You can take opposite elbows behind your back. Same thing, switch the grip. Or you can take reverse prayer. So the focus here is on that front body line. So don't worry about what's happening with your arms and your shoulders so much that you collapse out of the shape or you back out of the shape. Legs are still the main focus. They're still the foundation. They're still the grounding. And then the front body length, again, still the focus. So the arms are to add, not to subtract. Now, if your hands are clasped above your head, grabbing opposite elbows, you're going to want to interlace your hands behind your back, wrap your shoulders on your back. We're going to lean forwards on the inhale, and on your exhale, spring onto your right leg. Now, again, think about the lift. So pull your shoulder blades back, elbows lifted, back leg lifts, low ribs lift. Abdominal wall lifts. And breathe here. Another breath in. As you breathe out, hinge forward, forward fold, release. Halfway lift, breath in. Exhale, fold down. Flat back, inhale, stand up, reach up. Exhale, hands come down to your side. Step your feet together to touch. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hinge forward, forward fold. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, plant your hands. Please step back, high plank. Big toes come together to touch. Right hand walks just a little bit more forwards on the mat. So not extensively, just a tiny bit. Pivot onto the baby toe edge of your right foot. You can always step your left foot halfway up the mat to support this side plank. Spine is long, so you're trying to draw your sacrum towards your right heel. You can also float your left leg. All right. So you're going to take your left foot, somehow it's gonna get up to where your left hand would normally be, and we're gonna come into warrior two. So your left foot, hoop, pivot onto your right foot, come on up, whoop, warrior two. If you got lost along the way, your left foot is forward, your right foot is backwards, you're pivoting your torso towards the right side of your mat, and you are in warrior two. Somehow, some way, it happened. Good. Inhale, straighten it all out, reach up. Exhale, open up, warrior two. Inhale, straighten, reach. Exhale, open, warrior two. Inhale, straighten and reach. Exhale, open up, warrior two. Inhale, exalted warrior, slide your right hand down your right leg, left arm reaches up and back. You can keep your left fingertips reaching back, or you can cup the back of your head with your hand. Chin tucks down so that your low ribs get contained here, and then lift your elbow and your gaze towards the ceiling as you bend more deeply into your left knee. And try to let your head hang into your left hand. As you breathe in, stay as you are, but straighten out your left leg. As you breathe out, reach your left fingertips forwards and down, Trikonasana. So personally, I like to take a little pause in Trikonasana, right hand to the sacrum, and angle your sacrum towards your right heel. So that helps to lean your torso back. Now, if you need to come out of the shape a little bit in order to do that, come out of the shape a little bit. If you can touch all the way down while keeping your low ribs contained, you left side body long, your right side body contracted. Cool. Whatever. It doesn't change who you are as a person. The journey is what matters. How's that for some yoga stuff? If you need to have a block underneath your left hand, do that. Or you can just use your left shin. So, come into the shape that your body needs today. And keep your left leg straight. If your right hand wants to reach up towards the ceiling, you can do that. If your gaze wants to go up towards the ceiling, you can do that. If your gaze wants to look down towards your left foot, look down towards your left foot. If you look down towards your left foot and you notice that your left shoulder is rolling forward, spiral it open. Good. Another breath in here. And then as you breathe out, we're going to transition to a wide-legged forward fold. So bend into your front knee. Pivot all 10 of your toes towards the long right side of your mat with a slight pigeon toe. So you might need to adjust where your feet are. Hands underneath your shoulders. And then pull your weight more forward. So your heels are still down, but your weight's forwards. Inhale, lift and open your chest. And as you exhale, pull up through your inner thighs and bow over top of your legs. Squeeze your quadriceps to the bone as if it's the only job that you have in life. Pull your quadriceps in and up. And then try to drop your head, your neck, and your shoulders. Good. Inhale, halfway lift. And then exhale, pivot yourself back forwards. We're going to flow through your choice of vinyasa, or you can go straight to downward facing dog, or you can hang out in child's pose. We are going to meet in downward facing dog in just a few breaths before we go to the other side. All right, walk your big toes together to touch. Inhale, come forward, high plank. Walk your left hand just a tiny bit more forwards on your mat. Pivot onto the baby toe edge of your left foot, right arm reaches up. You can pause along the way, take your right hand to your sacrum to help you lengthen your spine a little bit more. You can also step your right foot halfway up the mat to help support the shape. You could also, if you want, hover your right foot. So it's up to you, whatever variation, whatever shape works best for your body, wherever your gaze needs to be. And again, we're going to come into that warrior two here. So your right foot is going to go to where your right hand would normally be, and you're going to pivot yourself open facing the left side. And up. So whatever actions you needed to do to get there, find yourself in warrior two, right foot forwards facing the left long edge of your mat. Take a moment. As you breathe in, reach up, lift it through your right leg. Exhale, open up warrior two. Inhale, straighten and reach. Exhale, open warrior two. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, open. Now this time, stay in warrior two legs. Inhale, exalted warrior. So left hand travels down your left leg. Right arm reaches up and back. You can keep reaching back through your fingertips or cup the back of your head. Turn your chin down. Contain your low ribs. Feel your abdominal wall tighten up. And then lift your elbow and your gaze towards the ceiling. Try to drop your head down. So soften your chin. And bend more deeply into your right knee. As you breathe in, straighten out your right leg. And as you breathe out, change your arm position. So reach your right fingertips forwards and down. Now, in the you would like to, you can pause with your left hand on your sacrum and help to negotiate your sacrum towards your left heel, spinning your chest more open. Right hand can be anywhere on your right leg, just not over top of your knee. Or you could put it on a book, a block, or if your sideways stays long, whoop, you can come to the outer edge. And if you like to, you could reach your left fingertips up. The one thing I would prefer you try to avoid is the collapsing forward action. So really think about this as a nice long line, heel, sacrum, base of your skull, coccyx. In whatever shape, whatever depth, in order to do that. And as you breathe out, you're gonna soften your front knee, pivot all 10 of your toes towards the long left side of your mat. Find your feet here. So feet slightly pigeon-toed, but parallel to each other. Hands underneath your shoulders, inhale, halfway lift, and as you exhale, bow forwards and down. Hands are light here, so you can keep your hands underneath you. You could take your hands to your outer feet, outer ankles. You could take your hands up above you, get a little crack out of your back. You could take that reverse prayer. You could also reach your hands under. There are so many arm variations in this shape. Just take whatever your body needs and do whatever works for you to pull your weight more forwards. And then squeeze your quadriceps if you are not already. Especially if you're very open in your hamstrings. Squeeze your quadriceps. Good. One more breath. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, pivot yourself back forward. Step back, your choice. Vinyasa, down dog, high child's pose. Notice how your body is feeling here and now. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, look forward between your hands, bend your knees, and you're going to hop your feet outside your wrists. Malasana. Squat pose. That was good. All right, so for Malasana, I really like getting a little bit of a wrist stretch here. So backs of your hands come together. Drop down through your pelvis. You can always sit up on a block, a book, or you can skip it and just drop your bum to the floor. Try to roll your shoulders onto your back, opening up through your collarbones here. And then try to put a little bit more weight into the baby toe edges of your feet, which will engage your external rotators so that your knees will open themselves up. Close your eyes and find your breath. Feel the length in your spine, the heaviness of your pelvis, the lightness of the crown of your head. Exhale, sit yourself down on your bum. I'm going to pivot around, but you're going to stay as you are. Or you can pivot if you want to. Your choice. I'm going to lie down. Oh, wow, just that feels good. All right, take your right ankle crossed over top of your left thigh. If you want, you could put a block or a book underneath your left foot just to give it a little bit of a raise. If you happen to be close to a wall, you might also decide to put your left foot on that wall and then scoot your bum closer to the wall to bring your thighs closer to you. So you have so many choices here. You can also wrap your hands around your left shin or hamstring if you don't feel like scooching yourself closer to a wall. Focus on that external rotation of the right femur bone in your hip socket. So we're focusing on the femur bone moving, which will then trigger the knee to open away from your torso, but you're not focusing on your knee moving. So it's more the femur bone rotating. You always want to pull the awareness of the action of the movement to your torso. All right, we're going to take this into a twist. So release your leg if you have it. If you are closer to the wall, this isn't going to work so well for you. Sorry about that. You can just scooch over to the other side, and then you can do the twist separately. So if you're at the wall, take your left ankle across over top of your right thigh and take your shape there, your external rotation. If you're away from a wall, then you'll take the twist here. And start to let your breath slow. Let your shoulders soften. Notice how strange it is that all of a sudden you bring awareness to a certain area of your body and you realize there's some tension there. All right, we're gonna come back to center and switch sides. So if you're at the wall, now you're gonna scoot yourself away from the wall and you're gonna take your twist right and left side or left and right side. If you are away from the wall, you're gonna take your figure four. So again, you could put your right foot on blocks, you can reach around your hamstring or your shin. And that external rotation is happening from the femur bone pivoting in that ball and socket hip joint. So if you are twisting, you're going to twist the other direction. If you are taking that figure four, you are going to come into the twist. So any variation of the twist that serves your body here today. Notice if any bits of tension have crept up into strange places. For me, it's that twisted shoulder. For some reason. When you feel about even, come back to center and find yourself in some neutralizing position. So for some people, that will be just pausing in center. For some people, it'll be a happy baby. For some people, it'll be a bridge pose. Just whatever it is that your body needs. One of the ones I actually really like is a Supta Balasana, so a supine child's pose here, where the knees are hugging out and wide, and then the heels drop down towards the pelvis. Wherever you are, whatever you need to do, just spend a few moments to do it and then release out into Shavasana. Give yourself some time and some space and As always, I know that you are not necessarily in a room with people, and Shavasana is a thing that has to happen. Please, Shavasana is such a privilege, and it is such an important part of this yoga practice. So please give yourself a few moments, a few minutes, a few songs to be here, to be still, to release, to soften. Take a breath in and out. I thank you so much for taking this time to share this space. Namaste.